છાન એમનો કૂદ્યું.
Good afternoon, everyone. Hope all of you are all right. As always, a pleasure to be with all of you. So I think we still have a few people joining in. Good afternoon. So good. So before I begin, just a couple of points. I've already uploaded the sports overview presentation and as well as the presentation for this module also, right? So. Because there was a request that, you know, for some people had requested that if you can share the slides before the session starts, it could be useful reference points. So I try to do that for pretty much all the modules. So I already uploaded the slides for the next module in inventory management, this current module of inventory management, right? And actually, a bit more I forget, yes. The section A, right? The groups, right, I have not received yet. In case, you know, I forgot who it was, right? Whoever was the concerned person, right? Whenever you get some time, kindly do that maybe by tomorrow or day after tomorrow. Would that be all right?
Yes, sir. I'll mail.
Rhythm, thank you so much. Right? So, whenever it's done, yes. Just let me know so that, you know, I can upload it. We'll treat by
one. Yes, sir. Also,
your word will be
mine. Yeah, the groups are made. I just forgot, sir.
Are you? Rhythm, how are you? You deserve capital punishment, huh? Such a big crime. This module inventory management. In case anybody has any question related to sports overview, I'm happy to take it. Otherwise, we can directly jump into the multi-period models, right? Single period, some of it we already covered, right? Amusement model, critical fractile, converting critical fractile into a number, etc. etc. So, anybody has any sort of question, confusion? All good? It's okay. If everybody's comfortable, let me jump into inventory. I hope everybody remembers, right? First year, you had some discussions around continuous review models, periodic review models. You also talk about quantity discounts, right? A little bit. So, continuous reviews, you keep a continuous tab on inventory. I mean, generally not manually. It's more a question of, you know, when you scan something, the inventory database automatically gets updated. At the moment you hit a threshold, which is called the order point, the order EOQ mode. So this is fixed, this is fixed, right? In periodic review, you come to the end of a period, right? And then you order this much quantity, right? So this is periodic review, right? So this I think everybody knows, should not be a problem. What we'll try to do today is basically talk of multi-period systems, right? Multi-period, right? What are these multi-period systems? See, in single period, if you are not able to sell the item within the period for all practical reasons, right, for all practical purposes, the problem was that the item loses a substantial chunk of its value and you end up salvaging that, right? In multi-period models, that's not necessarily the case. The item can continue to be there for multiple cycles of replenishment. What do I mean by this? If you don't sell something now, sell it tomorrow, day after tomorrow, day after tomorrow, day after tomorrow. So the item can be carried over is what I'm trying to highlight. It's possible to inventory it without a significant reduction in its value. So multi-period models, right? These are all multi-period. So we'll try to go with multi-period models, right? Now, within the multi-period models, let's start with something very, very basic, right? Something very, very basic. What is this basic thing? The first thing that you would like to sort of quickly brush up on is the EOQ formula. Right? Just to be clear, if you are setting it up, think of it as setup cost. If you're ordering it, think of it as ordering cost, which frequently includes the transportation cost also, right? Because the driver is the same, right? Per order, the same driver, right? So depending on the context, the same formula could become rho 2d C0 by ordering cost by H, right? And what is holding cost? Holding cost is incurred when you keep something inventory. And I think everybody knows it. Two interconnected ways of flow referencing it. One is something like this, right? So imagine you want to keep a watch, right? Let's say which is worth 1,500 in inventory for, I mean, not you want to, you end up keeping it, let's say, for 1 month. Right? And it so happens that the company has decided its inventory. I'll just tell you how it is decided. The inventory holding cost, let's say, is 100 rupees per month. So what it means per unit per month? So if you keep this watch in stock for 1 month as inventory, the inventory holding cost that is incurred is 100 rupees. So that is the absolute value approach. A more preferred approach is something like this, that you try to save 24% per unit time, so per year. In other words, if you keep something in stock for a year, for a time period, right? The inventory holding cost will be 24% of the product cost. That's how you calculate inventory holding cost, right? So you are keeping something in stock. You are keeping something in stock. So percentage of product cost. And just remember one small thing, which I think everybody knows. The idea should be dimensionally consistent, right? So for example, if you want to understand this is yearly, what will be monthly? Just divide it by 12. Weekly, divided by 52. Daily divided by 365. Why I'm telling you this is in this EOQ formula, this H, which is a percentage of product cost, right, percentage of product cost, is used in the same units as demand. If demand is yearly, take holding cost yearly. Weekly, weekly. Just be dimensionally consistent. All of this you already know. You don't really need to do that, right? So this was the expression. DS, as I said, think of it as ordering, transportation. Don't get worried about context, right? So this was EOQ. Okay. Now, within the EOQ, how do you get this EOQ? I think, again, everybody remembers, right? It's a sum of ordering cost plus holding cost plus transportation, plus procurement cost, purchase cost, right? Under scenarios which we covered today, because you already know how to handle discounts, if discounts are not given, product cost does not depend on how much you are ordering. 100 kharido, same price. 1,000 kharido, same price. Right? If you buy 100, it's the same price. If you have 1,000, it's again the same price. Right? So whatever be the amount that you're purchasing, it does not matter. So if you want to find the optimal ordering quantity, because change in ordering quantity does not lead to change in procurement cost, this will be tending to zero if you try to differentiate. So basically, the game becomes the one of ordering cost and holding cost. What is ordering cost? Ordering cost will be obviously number of orders into cost per order, right? If the demand is D and number of order size is Q, this will be the number of orders, right? Or S, whatever you want. Holding cost. Holding cost is, see, imagine you are ordering 100. No, your optimal order quantity comes to be 100. So you start with 100, right? Next is the daily consumption. Again, let me take it fixed just for the moment. We'll bring in uncertainty. So 100, it becomes 90, it becomes 80, it becomes 50, 40, 30, 20, 10, right? So some of the units spend a lot of time. Some of the units spend very little time. Right? Your unit last may sell. Whatever unit is sold last, it will spend a lot of time in the system. And some of the units will be spending very little time in the system. Right? So if that is the case, what we are going to do is, Abhishek, I'm going too fast, huh?
Yes, sir.
Not to worry. See, this is, plus one, oh my God, right? Meghna, you broke my heart, not a problem, right? Anybody else has to say plus two, that's perfectly fine. Right? It's okay. I'll try to go slowly. I thought, I know all of you are already well versed with all of this. Kya bhi shay bhul gaye kya?
Thoda bahut yaad hai.
Not a problem. No, some memories have been imprinted of some some distant time. Absolutely fine. No worries. I'll try to go slowly. Right. So the point is ordering cost okay? Just a quick check. Ordering cost, is the ordering cost part okay?
Yes.
Okay. All right. So in holding cost, remember, holding cost is the act of keeping something in stock, right? Holding cost is the act of keeping something in stock, right? The point is, if you're keeping something, the question becomes, how much are you keeping? So as I was saying, that if you order 100 units and daily consumption is 10 units per day, right? The initial set of units will be spending very little time in inventory. But the wins, once, for example, the 10 to 0 transition, it will take far first day, second day, third day, fifth day, seventh day, 10th day, right? So that is why what we say, let's look at the average inventory. Make sense? Balances out, right? Balances out. So average inventory will be, you go from Q to 0, then again stock comes Q to 0, Q to 0. Right? So average inventory becomes Q by 2. This is the average inventory, which you are keeping on an average. Into the cost of keeping that inventory, percentage of product cost. Okay, holding cost, right? In effect, what I'm claiming is the total cost is nothing but the sum of holding cost plus ordering cost and the third cost, which is we are taking it to be zero, right? So holding cost will be equal to Q by 2 into H, which can be written as IC, plus D by Q into C0, S, whatever you want to call it. The only thing which is a decision variable is Q, right? So differentiated with respect to Q, you can see minus 1 upon Q square, it will come, this will become H by 2. Once you differentiate, what you get is Q is equal to root S by H. The purchase cost, remember, the third is purchase cost, right? Purchase cost, because under this assumption, when no discounts are being given, whether you're buying it 10 into one go, whether you're buying 100 in one go, whether you're buying 200 in one go, if it does not matter, purchase cost will be independent of ordering quantity. So the relationship, if you try to differentiate with respect to Q, does not matter. So this will go to zero, right? Right? So that is why, after differentiating, you get the usual expression that we have, root 2 by H. Just to clarify, S could be ordering cost also, ordering plus transportation also. H is holding cost, which is often expressed as percentage of product cost, or sometimes percentage of product cost. Groups, authors, researchers. This could be concepts. Don't worry too much about the nomenclature, right? Okay. Any confusion so far? How did we get this? How did we get that? Etc. Everybody is comfortable, right? Just a quick sort of brush up of what
you, pretty much you everybody knows. Like EOS, right? Here.
Which one?
Q, which we are speaking about, is EOS or
EOQ, right?
Sorry, EOQ, sorry.
Yeah, correct. Absolutely correct. Right? So that's basically EOQ. This is nothing but EOQ, optimal order quantity, economic order quantity, right? Okay. So I hope everybody is comfortable with this. Also, is sorry. Oh, no, no, no. CO is the cost of ordering. See, when you order something, right, there will be no some paperwork which is involved, some processing which is involved, some handling which is involved. So all of it comes under the a bit of ordering cost. And remember, sometimes there's a transportation also involved if you are paying it. See, what is the trade-off? Let me explain, right? I think that's a fair one. See, that will not take me more than a couple of minutes. See, the trade-off is, if you want to order 1,000 units, right? You could have one order of 1,000. You could have, other end of the spectrum, you can have 10 orders of 100, let's say. Somewhere in the middle, you could have two orders of 500, right? And all of these are just permutations. You will have thousands of such permutations which are possible. Essentially, Q star is an attempt to find which is the best permutation, which is the steepest option. And remember, what is the trade-off? The trade-off is, if you go with this option, option A, in option A, you will order only once, so ordering cost will be low, but a massive number of units has to be kept. Accordingly, holding cost will be high. In option B, you are ordering many things, many times. So ordering cost will be high, but for each order, holding cost will be low. So you're just trying to find the point where the two costs are balanced. And that point is what we have to call EOQ, as some of you might remember, first year, right? So this is your holding cost. This is your ordering cost. This is your total cost. And this lowest point is what we like to call EOQ. I think everybody is comfortable with this, right? So if everyone is comfortable, or in case there is another question, I'm happy to take it. All good? Right, so for the rest of the program, if you are comfortable, if there are no more questions, then it's my job to ask questions. So let me ask a question, right? The question is this, right, at the bottom there. This is the data for a product, some demand, some ordering cost, some product cost, some percentage of product cost. Determine all these values, right? So the first box down the right, determine these. So solve it, all of you. Let me now request somebody to be act as the coordinator for this entire thing. Who should I request? Somebody who's right, maybe last one. Shruti, would you be kind enough to maybe tell us the answers after some time? Of course, everyone, but I just go by whatever is your answer, all right? Great. Solve it. Everybody knows, right? EOQ, cycle inventory, number of orders per year, total cost, average total time. Cut. Calculate. Who else? Okay. Other than Shruti. Oh. The same panel I have Ritika, Rituraj, Aditya, all of you, right? We'll go by whatever is your consensus view. Others, solve quickly. Cut. Don't waste too much time. You're not taking more than 3 minutes or so, right? This is basic first year. Solve. Cut. EOQ, kitna? Root 2 ds by h, right? Root 2 ds by h. I don't know how much I'm getting. I'm sorry, my bad. So, root 2 ds, 12,000 into 4,000 by 0.2 into 500. 12,000, 48, 96. Okay, I have got a couple of answers which are roughly 980 or so, right? Okay, seems to be 980. Should be correct. If so many people are getting, it should be correct, right? 980. So 980 seems to be correct. That's EOQ. Remember, cycle inventory, right? What is cycle inventory? Because these are replenishment cycles, right? We call these replenishment cycle 1, 2, 3. So basically, in a cycle, what happens is EOQ aata hai, order aata hai, order comes, then you deplete. Order comes, deplete. So on an average, this will be the cycle inventory on an average, right? For this problem. So Q by 2, 490, as some of you have already pointed out, right? Simple enough. What will be the number of orders? Number of orders is again straightforward, right? See, 12,000 in a year, we have to make it meet a demand of 12,000. And every time you are ordering 900 something, right? 980 or so. 12970. Yeah, roughly, you know, 12 points, roughly 12-ish. Okay. So 13. See, again, the good thing is because EOQ curve is flat, right? So rounding off, we don't worry too much. Slightly left, slightly right. The cost does not change by much. So that's why we don't worry too much about rounding. Flat, right? I mean, slightly here, we don't worry too much about exactly. So it does not make too much of a difference, right? Total cost, how much is total cost? Oh, 97. Oh, great. So total cost, for those of you who remember, just for the moment, let's not include procurement cost. Total cost will be sum of ordering cost. Ordering cost is number of orders into cost per order. And for those of you who remember, I mean, this is just a rough estimate, right? If it's decimal, take the decimal. I mean, of course, in real life, you will have to have an absolute number, sorry, a whole number. But in this problem, it's all right. So 48,000, right? And remember, EOQ point pay, on the point of EOQ, both these costs are equal. So automatically, it will be roughly 96,000. So this is ordering cost. Holding cost will be average inventory into holding cost, right? So this will be holding. So this plus this. Anybody who's not getting the value which Mega gave, roughly 98,000, roughly 5. Anybody who's not getting? Vikas, Saransh, are all of you getting 98,000? Vikas, are you here? We're enjoying your lunch or post afternoon siesta possibly. Where are you stuck, Vikas?
So I'm in Kolkata.
Oh, achha, I meant in the problem, but okay. To know. That's perfectly good to know, right? But on the in the problem, where are you stuck?
I got it, sir.
Okay, got it. Perfectly fine. Good to know that you're in Calcutta. Where in Calcutta?
So it's near the Ruby Hospital.
Okay. Nice. I have a quick question. If we had a breakup of month-wise or weekly demand, then can least total cost or least unit cost would have given better results? Ask a bit. Okay, yeah, it's a question with reference to. Okay, let's put it here. 97 is fine. It's fine, right? I hope everybody is using the same logic, right? Total ordering cost plus total holding cost. Ordering cost is number of orders into cost per order. Holding cost is average inventory into the cost of that average inventory. Okay. Sum the two together, get the total relevant cost. Of course, procurement cost companies incurring. But this was the question. Right. So if you had a breakout month-wise or weekly demand, yes, right? See, short answer, no. Remember, because that was there when demand was much more dynamic. We have looked at it shortly. What we'll do is we'll make the demand uncertain. Right? And that way demand will be changing monthly. So the beauty is because it's a multi-period model, we will go with safety stock. We are still not talking of safety stock. Remember, this is just a quick brush up of all of us, sort of so that all of us are on the same plane. And then we'll try to bring some more competitive. So short answer, no, because demand is uncertain. That works when the requirement is certain but changing. What I'm saying is in those models, if you remember, because those were related to MRP, material requirement planning, right? There you knew for certain 100, then 120, then 130, 140, right? So these are changing but certain. But demand is uncertain. Right? So that's the distinction. So that's why safety stock is the way to do that. Okay, everybody okay? Everybody's okay with this? Anybody stuck at any place? Total cost? Please do not hesitate, right? If you have any sort of confusion, stop me. Because we'll try to build on this. Anybody who's not getting total or even EOQ is on math, I will be happy to explain once more.
Sir, can you explain cycle inventory? Like order?
Sure. Yes, absolutely. Why not? Yes. See, cycle inventory. Why are we calling it cycle? Because it's a multi-period model. I mean, think of it like, you are running a small store and Pepsi distributor keeps on coming and coming and coming. So multiple replacement cycles. Right? Which is different from the way an airline would operate, the way a newspaper would operate. Today's newspaper, tomorrow you don't use it. There is no carryover. These are called multi-period models. And there are multiple replenishment cycles. So that's why we think of something called cycle inventory. So what is cycle inventory? Eight bar mein kitna aaya, right? But that is total, right? That is the order. Order quantity cannot be the inventory, right? Because that is the beginning, end. So what it says, if you start with EOQ, consume, end. QQ, consume, end. So it's as if throughout this cycle, on an average, you are keeping Q by 2. So that's why we call it a cycle inventory. Cycle inventory. On an average, aap kitna rakhe. And typically, as you can see, cycle inventory should be half of the quantity ordered. Rahul, is it okay?
Yes, sir. Okay.
Great, great, great. Anybody else has, anyone else has any other question? EOQ, total cost, or anything else for that matter, right? The last thing which is remaining is flow time. So flow time, anybody remembers first year Little's Law? I must have bored you by telling you that Little's Law is the, it's my opinion, not some expert's opinion. So in my opinion, Little's Law is the single most important concept in the first year operations, right? The relationship between throughput, flow rate, and inventory, right? Basically, distance is equal to speed into time, right? If you remember. So flow rate, right? Flow rate or flow time, the two are inverse. So flow time, just hear me out. Am I correct in saying that if you have 100 units, right? And the consumption rate is 10 per day, average unit would be spending how much time in the system? 10 days, right? If this is the average inventory, 10 days, right? On an average, how much time period does elapse between orders? More appropriately defined as what is the average amount of, what is the amount of time which an average inventory spends in the system? Right? On, for example, see why this is such a crucial metric, right? Let's try to understand. Suppose now if I continue the same example, right? 100 says zero, right? So am I correct in saying that the if the consumption rate is 10 per day, these units will have spent only one day in the system? These units will have spent 2 days in the system, and there will be some units will have spent much more spare time in the system. Right? So that is why we are worried about on an average kitna hai. Right? So typically the way to solve it is cycle inventory by demand. Q by 2. The reason why flow time is considered to be such a crucial metric is because fundamentally it tells you, as I said, how much time on an average is a unit spending in the system. And the lower the value, it means more efficient you are. It means you are quicker in converting inventory investment into returns. Cut. You're able to do it quicker and quicker. So that's a very, very, very good indicator of how good or bad your system is. Flow time. Right? Is everybody okay with flow time? What I mentioned about just flow time? On an average, what is the average amount of time spent by your unit in the system?
So D is the daily demand, right? There.
Daily. See again, daily demand. Up करोगे तो time जो है days में आएगा. Weekly लोगे तो time week में आएगा, right? Should not make a difference, right? Right, Abhishek?
हाँ, वो मतलब rate. I mean, it is.
It's a rate. कुछ भी. अगर day में है तो आपका flow time days में है. Week में है तो flow time will come in weeks. So basically, equivalent basis. What else? Flow time is everybody okay? If all of you are okay, just can somebody quickly tell me what is the average flow time for the system? I forgot. Q was, I think, 980. By monthly demand is 1000, right? So 4900, right? I don't have the answer, right? Roughly 4.49, right? I think in months, right? If I'm not mistaken, in months. Take a month. Great. Is everybody okay with this? Anybody who's not clear? Because now we will sort of build on this. The job is to build on this model. This, all of you already knew. Major part of it. Maybe some of the terms are new. It's fine. All good?
Sir?
Yes, please.
One thing, like we are using month because we have taken the monthly demand.
Right.
And Q by 2 will remain the constant, right?
Right, because that is the optimal order quantity, right? Order to nahi hai. If you take demand as monthly, the rate of time will also be monthly. If you take it yearly, demand here will be yearly. Daily. So, consistent dimensional consistency will always be maintained.
Okay.
So, absolutely correct. Excellent. All good. No confusion here. Everybody is on, all of us are on the same page, I hope. Okay. It's good. If everyone is on the same page, let's try to now move beyond this. Everybody is happy with the flow time, etc., right? Because that's an important concept. And you know, sometimes people come back and say, hey, that's a problem there, you're not clear on this, etc. See, the reason why flow time is so crucial is that it also gives you so many other insights. What kind of insights are we talking about? So imagine, right? I'll give you a small, another quick example, right? So suppose you are running a small fast food outlet, right? Or a quick service restaurant, right? And what you want to do is, let's say, just for the heck of it, let me take something. Let's say, you know, you're selling some pizzas, right? And each of these pizzas has 1:1 ratio of your topping, right? One topping point. You might say, what am I selling pizza here? But okay. So the point is, yeah, this is topping, right? And you want to understand it, okay, topping career, if I order 1,000, you know, if my optimal order quantity for ordering toppings is 1,000, on an average, roughly, my topping, how much time does it spend here, right? So straightforward, you don't have to do anything. You just do it by half, right? And divide it by the average rate of selling pizzas. So for example, you come today 7 days, which you might be comfortable with. But it might come 20 days, which you might not be comfortable with. So we might say, "Arey, nahi yaar, 20 days is tricky, right? Maybe, you know, there are freshness issues, there are quality issues, there are hygiene issues. So then maybe you might want to reduce it." See, flow time, right? It's all about little stuff. So flow time, that's when understanding of flow time is very important. Okay? So spend some time with flow time, right? And see whether it makes sense. All right? All good? Right. Okay. Hello. So now allow me to jump. Yes, please.
But still, it is the average.
Yes, correct.
But the example that you gave, the extreme, that is the at the end of the inventory,
right?
And inventory cycle,
right?
The freshman, if you take the same example, the flow time, it will create a problem.
Yeah, I got it. What you're saying is, you know, yeah, average inventory, last month I will not spend that much time. I think that's the point, right, Ritik?
Yes.
Yeah, true. See, it's aggregate. Some of the items will be delayed. So the point, if you are comfortable with this average, then it's all right. But if you're not comfortable with the average, then it's much more problematic. Your point is, extreme pe kya hoga? Would the extreme wala bit more delayed? Yes. But see, the problem is, can we tag every item? Yes, we can tag every item, and that's not a problem. But averages also help us in process planning. Aggregates also help us in process planning, right? If the last one is very much delayed, then it's a problem. But aggregates also help us. So that is the whole point, that aggregates allow you to visualize the process at a macro level. If the last one, see, can we decide how much time would the last unit spend in the system? Yes. We can decide, right? Consumption rate, just take Q and map it to D. We'll come to know what will be the last unit where it will be sold on an average. Right? On an average, it will be sold. So again, this is for the last unit. This is for the average. Both of these have to work together. Both of these have to be worked. But your point is absolutely valid, that averages may at times hide information. So that is the point, and that is something I completely agree. Because averages might be misleading. As you said, last wala could be different value. So that's a very valid point. So again, we cannot look at egg metrics in isolation. But I completely agree to your point. Any idea what the relationship between flow time and throughput? Sorry, not throughput, my bad. Turnover, what will be the difference? What will be the relationship between, you know, for inventory turnover? Inverse, absolutely correct. Kitni bar inventory turn karo? What we're saying is, turn karne pe time kitna aa raha. So these two things are typically inverse. Again, these are just small things, you know, which when you are reading some article or trying to set a policy or trying to sort of communicate with someone, these are just small things to keep in your mind. Okay. All good. If this is clear, what we will now do is we'll sort of start the discussion for this course. This was primarily sort of a refresher on what we already knew. And now what we will try to do is, rather than working with a single product, we'll now try to bring multiple products. I mean, what do I mean by this? So for example, if you're a Colgate, right, what you do is you might have toothbrushes also, you might have toothpaste also, you might have mouthwash also, right? If you are a Britannia, right, you might have some dairy. I mean, dairy works slightly differently, but you have, might have one type of item, second type of item, third type of item. If you are a Dell, for example, right, you could have laptops also, you could have desktops also, you could have tablets also, right? Apple, I don't even talk about, right? Apple, to Apple fans are already there, right? You must have seen the mad thing which has just come out, right? Could you, whatever, just put Apple and sell, right? Of course, I'm not the target segment, so I'm not fit to comment. Anybody has seen what has come out just now?
Yes, sir.
Right? Is it really worth it, Tushir? Okay, don't answer that question. Yes, it's not relative, right? Willingness to pay. So I think it's finally, after converting, it comes out to be some 60,000, 55,000, 50,000, 60,000 also, right? I mean, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes, sir. 58,000, 60,000.
पहले लोग किडनी मोबाइल के लिए किडनी भेज दो एंड यू नो उसके लिए कान भेज देते हैं व्हाई माय टू कमेंट राइट नॉट रियली द टारगेट आई एम पहले चाइनीज फोन लेते थे आफ्टर ऑल दोस इंसिडेंट्स आई स्टार्टेड मूविंग टू साउथ कोरियन फोन्स मे बी आई नीड टू मूव टू इंडियन फोन्स आल्सो पॉसिबल इन द शॉर्ट फ्यूचर बट या द पॉइंट इज देयर आर मल्टीपल आइटम्स टू बी हैंडल्ड टुगेदर राइट जस्ट एज अ बेसलाइन मॉडल विल इंप्रूव ऑन दिस जस्ट एज अ बेसलाइन मॉडल One very obvious way to, for example, if you're a Dell, right, to understand could be that, okay, there are tablets, there are laptops, and let's say there are desktops or all in ones, right? One option could be that I try to map all of these independent, iska EOQ separate, inventory policy separate. That's just one option, just as a baseline model. Okay? So what we'll do is we'll first just try to generate this mono baseline model and then try to refine it. How do you refine it? So basically we are moving something towards something called tailored aggregation. So that is the key concept for today. Okay? So let's try to understand. What I would request is look at the problem. The problem is pretty straightforward. Essentially, there are three types of products, light pro, medium pro, and heavy pro. Just the reference for the inventory management discussion that we'll have will be the Chopra book, right? For Chopra sports superwear, it was the Simchi Levy book. Now this discussion, if you want to go deeper, just look at the Sunil Chopra book, right? So basically there are three products, light pro, medium pro, and heavy pro, as the small problem calls it. There are some holding costs as a percentage of product costs, right? And the order cost is broken down into two. Order come transportation cost is broken into two. Something like a common order cost, which is the fixed part. So come to think of it something like this, that the cost of the delivery vehicle and the rest of it is handling cost, right? So the fixed part and the item specific part, the common part and the item specific part, right? So if you were to order only tablets or only light pro, the order cost that you incur will be the vehicle plus handling. So total will be 5,000, right? So as the baseline model, what we'll try to do is we will try to calculate the EOQ for all three and accordingly the number of orders and the total cost, which will just for the moment be only ordering cost plus holding cost. Okay? So I would request each of you to just take one of your choice. You know, some of us might like to take this, somebody might like to take something like this. Just see what are the values that you take. This is just a baseline model. Whatever we just now, usiko. Just calculate EOQ, just calculate N, just calculate total cost. Give it a go. Any one of these, not all, no need for a single person to do all three. Let's divide and conquer. Learn from our British overlords. Right? So, do it quick. Koi sabhi hai, anyone, right? And while just when you give the answers, I would request you to just indicate for which of these products, right? Just one time. Single person, Abhishek, for example, if you want, you can do for Light Pro. Somebody else can do for medium pro, somebody else can do for the heavy pro, right? So LMH, just take the values, 2 ds by h, 5,000, right? So calculate EOQ, number of orders and total cost. Anyone. No, I don't need to do all three. You just have to benchmark. This is the initial solution. We'll try to improve it. Give it a go. Shashank, tell me, Shashank, quick. Okay, we already have one answer. Okay, light pro 1096 seems to be correct. I think a lot of you seem to be getting 1096. Fine. And the moment, just for the moment, 1096 is what you're getting. And 347 also, excellent. Okay. So number of orders will be 12,000 by 1,096. 11, 12, put over, right? 1,200 by 347. If we go on, again, it will be 3.something, right? And similarly for heavy pro, some EOQ will come. Okay. Anybody who is not in, oh, okay, is anybody not clear on what is to be done? If you have completely lost you, please let me know. I'm happy to go back. Session one, start from here. I'm not joking. I'm serious, right? I'm happy to go back. Maybe if not the class, I can have arranged, you know, extra sessions. That's not a problem. For medium pro, 346, 347 seems to be the correct answer, right? And for the light pro, you know, people seem to be telling me 1,095, 96. Okay, rounding off, it's all right. Heavy pro, was anybody able to do it for quickly for heavy pro or just for, you know, benchmarking all of it? 109. All right. Great. Thanks, Ravish. Thank you, Karthikeyan, right? Thanks, everyone, right? So we have all the three answers in front of us, right? Again, the next step is to calculate number of orders, which will be D by Q. Demand layer, Q star, right? Demand layer, Q layer, right? So we can calculate that, right? Number of orders, basic unitary method, right? And total cost will again be the sum of ordering cost plus holding cost. Okay? So I presume, I assume, I hope something like this you are getting, right? There might be some errors here and there, which is fine. Not a problem. 1095. I think these similar seem to be okay with you, right? I mean, seem to be aligning broadly with what all of you were telling, right? Ostavia, right? What else? Cyclic ticket, this is fine. Ordering frequency is important. And you have the total annual cost. Right? I'll just give you a moment. If for those of you experiment, still calculating. Take a minute or two. No hurry. Get this, because now we'll improve the system. And then we'll improve it even further. So we will are targeting two levels of refinement in today's session. That is what we are interested in. I'll give you a couple of minutes. Give it a go. See, sometimes in calculations, you know, you're just a bit rough. I know it's boring, but you know, all of us are intellectual buddhi jeeves, you know, and nowadays it's a good term to use. Right? So calculations are boring, but okay, every once in a while it's good to do some calculations. Take your time. Give it a go. Anyone, right? If you do for one of these, you have got the hang of it broadly. Once you do for one of these, you've got the hang of it broadly. Okay? Take your time. I'll give you maybe a couple of minutes to try it out. And as always, if you're stuck, not clear, completely, you know, lost you, let me know, please. I'm assuming there is no problem here. If it pops up, you get in touch with me, it's not an issue. Okay, now becomes the question that what is the most obvious way to improve the system performance? Most obvious way. Abhi kya kare? Remember, what we're saying is, I don't want to you know, worry about 2+2, none of that nonsense, right? Let's keep it all separate. So, as Vikas pointed out, and I'm sure you know all of you, this is intuitive in some senses, that it makes sense for us to go with a common order. Why do you want to handle all of it differently? That's not a very incorrect, that is, there's a lot of logic in maintaining that. And would I be correct in saying that fundamentally, when we go for a common order, this is, can I show calculation cycle inventory for anyone? Yeah, sure. A good calculation to me. Rahul, were you able to get this much?
Yes, sir. EOK or calculator?
So, easy. You don't have to remember, at least for my courses, right? I always try to, you know, understand, right? So, EOQ behavior will be, basically, every time you have to order 1,095, 1,096 units, right? It will be consumed. Then another, you know, after zero, another order comes, 1095, consume. So it's as if the behavior is within a cycle. Within a cycle, you go from max to min. Max to min. So on an average, would I be correct in saying that you will be keeping this much? Which is why you like to what? Cycle. Is it okay, Rahul?
Yes.
Right? On an average. So it gives you an overview of the cycle. What about the cycle? So now coming back to the point of how do you save, how do you improve on this? Quite obviously, when you go for common orders, basically what we are saying is, it's not exactly that, but okay, you don't have to get a vehicle separate. In the same vehicle, put it and deliver. So would I be correct in saying that the common order cost will not be incurred again and again and again? Make sense? Common order cost will not be incurred again and again and again. Right? So now, the moment we do that, and this is an important point, that's why I'm explaining, you know, because the further refinement would actually follow from here. So now if you want to optimize the system, something like this would happen. Just hear me out. Because all the items are being delivered together, for each order, there will be the vehicle cost, the delivery cost, you know, and the processing and manual handling cost for all the three items. This will be the order cost on a per order basis. And if n is the number of orders, this will be the total ordering cost on an annualized basis. So far, so good. Holding cost was, remember, average inventory into holding cost. Now, average inventory will be Q by 2 into HC or IC, whatever you want to write. Okay? Percentage of product cost. Right? Am I correct in saying that N is nothing but D by Q? Kitna chahiye, kitna waste, right? 1000 orders, 1000 demand, 100 orders will be 100 order size will be a total of 10 orders. So if I use this here, basically the average inventory expression would be D into HC by 2N. Is everybody comfortable with this expression? Anybody who's not comfortable with the expression? Everybody's on board, right?
Sir, can you explain this again?
Yes, sure. Please, sir. That's a very fair point, yes. Total order cost is basically the truck cost. I mean, it's not that, but take a truck cost plus the specific cost. And this is on every order. And assuming there are N orders on an annual basis, the total annual order cost will be this much. Right? S being this one. Oh, sorry. Let me use the same nomenclature. So structure cost, specific cases. Now holding cost, all of us know, is average inventory. Right? Into the cost of that inventory, basically percentage of product cost. Average inventory is Q by 2. What you also know is that the number of orders will be equal to demand by order size. 1000 demand, order size is 500, there will be 2 orders. 1000 is the demand, 100 is the order size, there will be 10 orders. 1000 is the demand, 1000 is the order size, 1 order, right? So basically, I'm trying to use these two and put it here, right? So basically, Q by 2 will become D by 2N. Into HC, which is precisely what is put here. Is this okay now, everyone? Ritik, Meghna, and others also, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Feel free, I'll say, just because I explained it once, it's with you are well within your rights, so always, you know, question and come back. So please, at any point of time, feel free. Okay? So holding cost for the first one, holding cost for the second one, holding cost for the third one, total cost expression, total holding cost, total ordering cost. The only unknown here is N. Sorry.
Sir, one doubt.
Sure, yeah, please, mate.
So we are assuming that in each order, there will be some units of each type.
All three, yes.
Okay.
Yeah, that's true. In fact, that's precisely what we relax in the next refinement. That's precisely what we relax in the next refinement. So total order cost, the only unknown is N. Differentiate with respect to N, right? Get the expression for optimal number of orders. Right? Is everybody okay with this? Comfortable with this? Calculation, I mean, not calculation, conceptually, my question will come. Okay? Don't have to remember, right? Structure is the same as before. total multi cost, total ordering cost, sum, differentiate, get the value. Okay. Now what I would request all of you is try to see. Remember, we earlier had some explore values, right? Let's try to see that once you have this expression, we will again try to calculate what is the optimal number of orders in the joint case. We'll try to calculate total cost for the system. Okay? So just give it a go. Maybe I'll show you the data once more. You can take it down. So by the way, these slides are already there. So if you're more comfortable looking at the slides again and again, you can download it from Moodle and if you do that. So otherwise, I would request you to maybe just jot it down. And then I'll again go back to the expression page. As always, number of orders, there's something interesting which is going to happen. Number of orders and total cost. Those are the two things which we are interested in. Number of orders and total cost. Okay? So take it down. No hurry. And once you are done, maybe after a minute or two, I'll just move to this. Okay. Here we are calculating number of orders first and then from the. No, remember, EOQ is different. Right? EOQ. Okay. I got the question. So here calculating number of orders. Yes. So N, see, once you get the optimal number of orders, Q star, remember we already write, N is equal to D by Q. So Q kya hoga? D by N star. Right, Rithik? For quantity chahiye, to number of orders chahiye, toh quantity. Theek hai? So, brilliant. So if this, if you have taken down this data, let me go back to here. We already have a couple of answers. 1230 is the order point. But Meghna, if you don't mind, can you just also tell us the optimal number of order space, if that is all right? Others also, give it a go, right? See, typically what happens is, when you give something like this or some modified version of this in exam or quizzes, right? Calculation-wise, people end up making mistake. Conceptually, even if they're okay, calculation-wise, people sort of just lose it, right? Roughly 9.8, okay. Maybe I'll just wait for some, okay. Or Abhish is also good. So maybe seems to be correct. We'll just wait for maybe others to also catch up. Take some time, no hurry. I'll give you maybe 2-3 minutes to just go step by step by step, right? Step by step. Total order. Total order cost, total holding cost, 9.7, 9.75 seems to be correct. The ordering frequency seems to be correct. And once we have the ordering frequency, we can calculate the total cost also, right? Holding as well as ordering. Sum kar do, total barabar aa jaye, correct? So give it a go. No hurry, absolutely no hurry. Anybody who's not getting 9.75 or 9.7, okay, no, it's fine. 9.7, 9.7 something. Or somebody who's lost, exactly how do we do that? Take your time. Plenty of time. Okay, so 136,557. Okay. So if I were to just quickly compare, there seems to be a pretty significant reduction, all things considered, right? Pretty significant reduction, okay. Okay. Maybe I'll just give it some more time, something to others also. Okay. Oh, one more, all right, okay. Thank you. Okay. I think some people seem to be getting it. Okay, no, quite different. All right, so see, let's try to understand this. So I think this is what everybody seems to be getting, right? Okay, 9.75, all right, and 136 something. It is fine. So the behavior is interesting. I will draw your attention towards this which you all got just now, and the values which were there earlier. This one. Remember, it's the same data, right? It is the same data, right? So my limited understanding of this is that seemingly under a common approach, the items which were, when ordering independently, which were ordered much more frequently, their frequency of ordering comes down, and for the others it actually goes up. That would be an ordering, I don't know, that pretty decent interpretation of what we are getting. Under, when you were ordering independently, some items were ordered much more frequently, 11 times per year, 3.5 times and 1.1. And the moment you combine the system, 9.75, right? Which is fine. Again, it's end of the day, the proof of the law is in this cost reduction. So that which is nothing wrong. Right? End of the day, you're just interested in cost reduction, so there's nothing wrong there. But the point is that, is there a way for us to improve it even further? Think about it. I'm sure everybody knows the answer to this question. And that's how research progresses, right? Refinement. So I'm not satisfied with this answer. Maybe I want some further savings. So how do I bring more savings? And somebody already had asked a question, you know, around that theme. So maybe for what it was, right? But definitely, we need not order every product every time. Okay, that's one. Anything else which comes to mind, like, you know, what could be another potential improvement? Right. See, essentially, Vikas's, you know, argument could be that why should we, you know, just because we're ordering everything, why should we order everything again? So an interesting, you know, it's a very interesting argument. And the reason I see it's very interesting is basically, maybe, we'll see it in detail shortly. Just maybe what we do is, maybe there are some items which are delivered very, 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 very frequently. And there are some items, grouping, that's a very good point. Absolutely correct. Right? There are some items which could be delivered less frequently. Right? But remember, again, conceptually, I would still prefer the items to maybe come in single go, right? I mean, even, see, for example, the green wala item is not there every time. But maybe I would still prefer, whenever possible, for these to be tagged along. I mean, I don't want the green wala to come somewhere here, right? Because then the capital S would be incurred again. The fixed ordering cost would be incurred, that kind of defeats the major part of the reason why we are doing all of this. So maybe it makes sense for us to go for some degree of synchronization, right? Maximum chal rahe, going like this. And the less frequent one, for example, you know, you want maybe here, then here. Maybe do not want it here, each way, because then another S is incurred. And if, for example, if there's yet another item, right? Let me take, for example, yet another item. So that item might be even more infrequent, right? But again, I don't want this item to be coming in between. So basically what I'm claiming is that maybe there's a potential for us. There is a potential for us to set up a mechanism in which we have that one item comes very frequently. And sometimes the other items tag along, but my all saying is I do not want the other items to randomly pop up. Whether a weekly survey, so come in some of those weeks. Suddenly don't say any Thursday night or Tuesday. No. So that's what we want to do. So how do we set up that mechanism which ensures that we are able to synchronize pretty much everything, all of it put together. One item very, very, very frequently, relatively speaking. And some of the times, as I said, tag along. That is what going forward, what we are interested in. And what we'll try to do is, we will take a short break now. And once again, don't get, you know, worried about this formula. It's very convoluted, right? There are summation, this summation, logical. Logically, it's very simple. Once we come back, we'll take this up and see is there further refinement possible or not. The concept is technically called tailored aggregation, as I mentioned. Right? So we are good to go for a short break, 15 minutes or so. Right? Anybody has any question? I'm still here. Happy to take it. Otherwise, let's be back at 4:15. Right? Let's be back at 4:15.
Yes, sir. I just wanted to if you could go back to the slide where so I mean so initially we assumed that in every turn all the items would come right when we
right in the first model was each item is handled differently, so there is no degree of coordination at all.
Yes,
right.
Yeah, like the one after that.
Right. So after that, what we're saying is, no, let's bring all of them together, And the moment we did that, what happened was that the one which was ordered very frequently is now ordered somewhat less frequently. Right. And the ones which were ordered relatively infrequently are now ordered more frequently. So what we're interested in is there a mechanism, because what is happening is something which is otherwise very, very infrequently used. Very, very infrequently used, is also coming multiple times, 9.7, 10 times on. So that is what we're questioning. Is it really necessary? So within this, what was the question, Abhishek?
Yes, sir. So, I mean, I did not understand this part. Like how, I mean, so initially, when we joined the products, like all of them.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
So at that point of time, we still had like X number from Lite Pro, Y number from
LMP, right? So some from L, some from M, some and some from Lite, or so LMS, right? So light, medium, heavy. Yeah.
Yeah. So X from L, Y from M, and Z from
X. Yeah. Correct.
Yeah. Each and every time, right? Like when we
each and every time. So now what we're saying is, why do we require each and every time? Right? How do we do that? Is what we're interested.
But then, sir, I mean. If this is the annual demand, then I mean z number of times, I mean z into the number of times which we order is required, right?
So that will be the annual demand. Yes, correct.
Yes. So why so you mean to say, I mean okay, so you mean to say if H is required only in 2 weeks, then instead of having like the monthly shipment, will have two times that in 2 weeks.
The end of the day, maybe I will still meet the same demand, but how you meet the demand is what I'm questioning. Kisi ka demand agar slow moving hai, har hafte kyun la rahe
ho? Okay, so demand, yeah, so it's kind of like so we manage the fixed order cost with the holding cost, right?
Absolutely. So initially, right now we said common or fixed order cost. Now in the next model, we'll say even item specific order cost, we will try to optimize around that. Absolutely correct.
Okay,
so we'll take it up.
Yes.
Okay, we'll take it up once you're back. Think about it. If there's any further question, let me know. All right.
Okay.
So we can continue around along what we were discussing earlier. So now the article which I've shared, right, in the break. So if you get some time, do read that. It's an interesting article about Shopify. And I think people who have been interacting with me will know that. I've been talking about Shopify quite a bit for the last year or so. And recently what they have done is they have done some really interesting things with a company called Stripe. And they are truly, you know, setting it up to dominate in the world of commerce in general. So for people interested in retailing or consulting or those kind of things, maybe read a little bit more about, or even, you know, business models broadly, right? So what these are to, you know, what Shopify and Stripe are trying to do together. That is something really amazing. In fact, if you are interested, you know, just maybe go through this also. Those people who are interested, right? These are pretty good resources if you want to explore more. Anyway, so coming back to the idea, right? What we have done is step one, we took all of those independently. Step two, we said, let's take all of them together, all the items together. In step three, what we are doing is we're saying, oh, why do we want to take all the items all the time? So if the idea is, if let's say, for example, you are, right, you are, let's say, a Colgate, as I was mentioning earlier, right? And you are handling multiple items. What you try to do is trying to understand that, okay, if I'm selling toothbrushes, toothpaste, and, you know, mouthwashes, the most frequent one I will bring all the time. I will order all the time. The less frequent one will tag along some of the time, and the other one even less so, right? So that is in a nutshell broad idea. Right? What we want to do is, we want to club all of these together, right? We want to club all of these together. Okay. Now, if that's the case, how do we ensure that the system is even optimized? So I'll just go step by step. Right? The formula is, you know, very convoluted, it seems, you know, a lot of terms, this, that. The process is very straightforward. So I explain the step, and I'll also try to explain the logic of that step. Explain the step as well as explain the logic of that stuff. Take it. So now let me go back. So same problem, right? Because you want to be able to show that system is improving, right? You want to be able to show that, right? So now what we are trying to do is, we'll take this first system, and what we'll do is, let's say the step one is basically saying that try to calculate the optimal number of orders, assuming that each of them were ordered independently. Which is nothing but the first case that we did. Right? We already did that, right? That's the initial step, just to kickstart the process. Take care. So initially you do that, and you will get some number of orders. Something might be 11, something might be, you know, 5, something might be 3, something might be this, right? Which was it, right? It depends on values. I don't know. You already know the expression, right? So now what happens is, once we have identified the optimal number of steps, once you've identified the optimal number of steps for all the items, you take the one with the maximum frequency, basically for which it is optimal to order most frequently, and you keep it separate. Right? For the others, the less frequent ones, you take those less frequent ones. This is step two, right? Less frequent ones, you take those, and you again try to calculate a modified ordering frequency using this expression. And I would draw your attention between these two expressions. I hope you can see that the only difference is capital S is not there, right? And the reason is because these items, less frequent items, would only be tagging along. You're trying to understand that anyway, capital S would be incurred for the most frequent items. So what is the remaining cost is we are considering? Because capital S to anyway you'll be incurring, right? You're tagging. So tagging means something is already there. So that is why what we're saying is, for the less frequent items, you again calculate a modified ordering frequency, basically neglecting the effect of S. And once you do that, you will get some new values, which will be different from earlier values. Right? Earlier values would have been different. Now the new values would be different, right? So that is step two. In step three, remember, the problem is you want to ensure that the tagging is integer wise. Every second order, every third, you cannot tag along every 1.3 order. You cannot tag along every 5.4 order, right? So you have to ensure that the tagging is commensurate to an order which is coming, right? So that is why in step three, what we do is we take the most frequently ordered one, right? And take this modified ordering frequency for the less frequent ones. Take the ratio and put the ceiling operator, right? That you basically round it up, higher value, right? Round up. So other 11 by 6 are, so this becomes every second order. So basically, how do you read this new information? Should I tag along every second order, every fourth order, every sixth order? So this is what is being done. Step one, step two, step three. Step four is tricky. It's not tricky, it's just like, you know what? So I don't explain. Step four, once you have identified that because every second time, every third time, every fourth time, we'll be tagging along. Basically, what we are doing is we are using the same expression as before, by the way. Same expression, I just showed, right? Sure. Let's explain. Okay, I think there are a couple of questions. I'll explain it once more. So just give me a second. I'll just show you an expression. And after that, just remember this expression, right? And remember, S star is this much. Can you just remember this? I'll come back. So step one, calculate optimal ordering frequency independent. Okay? That is step one. Step two, remove the most frequent one. The less frequent ones, you take them up and calculate a modified ordering frequency by neglecting the effect of common order cost. Logic being, this would anyway be incurred for the one which is most frequently ordered. And in the third step, because the frequency could come, for example, revised frequency comes out, no, there should be six orders. Okay. So, and suppose the most frequently ordered one is 11. So what you're trying to say is, you cannot come, you have to be ensured that, right? Every first order, every same order, second order, third, just to align, you have to tag, right? You cannot tag on the 2.5th order. That's to be the second order or the third order. 2.5th order is nothing like that, right? So that is why this is an attempt to perfect the tagging, if I may. Right? So you divide 6 and 11, you take the modified value, right? This is upper value, right? Okay? And basically, it will calculate every second order you should come. Depends on the values. Every fifth order you should come. So that includes, that incentivizes you to go for perfect synchronization every except order. That was step three. And I hope the logic is also clear, step by step. In step four, again, I would refer you back to this expression, right? Just answer this and this. I will give you a moment to think about this. So this is nothing but optimal order, DUQ formula, right? And this is this. So I would request your attention now, because this is slightly where people get confused a little. Okay? Just look at this expression, right? I would again show you back the earlier one. It's structurally very similar, right? What is happening is, I just hear you, earlier you were having S plus SL plus SM plus SH. Now the problem is, this is not incurred on every order. If this is coming every second time, am I correct in saying that SL would be incurred once every two orders? Right? that is why what we are doing is that on a per order basis, it's as if that this is the contribution of that. I hope you're able to get every fourth order, every sixth order. So we are just understanding on a per order basis, what is the impact of that? That is why instead of having something like this, we have the impact of tag which is captured by revenue dividing it by MI. So this is the modified optimal order quantity. Once you have this for individual item, for example, finally I've got 12 items. So what you do is the for the other item, this is for the most frequent one. For the other ones, divided by, so for example, every second order may I come. So basically, there will be six orders of the every fourth order, there will be three orders. And this is your total cost expression, which is the total common order cost, total item specific cost, and this is the total holding cost. Take a moment to think, take a couple of minutes if you want to. Any confusion, any question, if you want me to start once more, I'm happy to do that. So take a moment, think about it. Yes, please, go ahead.
In step four, it included like the most like frequent one also, right?
Yes. Because otherwise you will miss out on the cost. So this is for the system, entire system. Including the most frequent one. Yeah, including the most frequent one. Right? So take your time. This IMI is not an issue. Think about the problem. Try to make sense of it. We'll solve the same problem once more using this approach. But before that, logic should be internalized. If you're facing problem or if you have not understood it, happy to explain it once more. Think about it. Just try to think about what is happening. Step by step by step. Is this a heuristic problem? Yeah. Very good question. This is a very good question. This is strictly speaking, this is a heuristic, strictly speaking. Because the issue is internal, the moment you convert it into an integer, that is a problem comes. But this is possibly as close to optimization as you can do, because this has been tested. You do a brute force search using all variables possible. This gives you pretty good results. This is pretty good results. Also, if most frequent is 11 and the other is 10, would we not have it every time if it's ordered? Not necessarily. See, question which is being asked is, would you want it to be? Because see, if you order it 10 to 11 also, then also it's suboptimal. See, any movement from the point of optimality would be suboptimal for the item. But remember, we are interested in system optimality, not item level optimality. Item level optimality is independent. Yes, but sir. Item level optimality did not lead to system level optimality, right?
So, sir, say for example, there are only two products.
Right.
And one of them number of times is 11 in a year. For the other one, it's 10 times.
Right.
So while ordering it, how will you do it? Like what would be the optimal case in this one?
Same case. See, this is when you are doing it independently, right? And the moment you remove the most frequent ones, see, just hear me out. See, I would like to highlight something. This has been put, interesting question. Just say no, and I'll explain the logic. Am I correct in saying that if this value is very low, the impact would be minuscule?
Yes.
Right? So far, so good. And because I am removing something, this value would only go up. Are you okay with this, right? So far?
Yes, sir.
So the outcome of this process is automatically that 10 will get pushed higher, no? See, number one, if S was very small, right? And that's the same to explain the scenario, right? If S is very small, and you're removing that S, in any case, this is going up. It's entirely possible that you come to items which will be brought in all the time. So it will all depend on values. Okay? If this is very high, so it might make sense that even though now you're ordering a larger quantity for the 10 orders wala rather than 11 orders wala, but because you are saving on some of this, it is entirely possible that you may want to order it only every second. So it's a trade-off. You go on this approach will capture the trade-off. And I said, it's as close to optimality as you can possibly get. As close to optimality as you can possibly get.
Okay.
So the process will take up.
Hello.
Process. Any question, any confusion? I'm happy to answer.
Yes, sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, in the value of n, like in the denominator, mi is in mi has been divided by like the some si by mi. So why is it not? Hello, sir.
You have lost connection, right?
Okay.
Can you repeat the point if you don't mind, please?
Yeah, sure, sir. So, sir, in the values of n, when we are calculating the value of n,
right.
In the denominator, mi is in the mi is divided by basically so si by.
Are we talking about this one, right?
Yeah, this, sir.
Yeah. Yes.
So, in the denominator, in the numerator, then why is it in the why mi is multiplied by?
Oh, yeah. I think another excellent question. Another excellent question here. I think maybe I possibly need to go step by step. Okay, just give me a second. No, I'll possibly not explain step by step. Just give me a second. I'll put up a backside. Just give me a second. Try to step, no, go step by step. I think that's another very good question. Okay, so I'll explain the process. Just for the benefit of others, the question is about this expression, right? That's the question for the benefit of others. What is happening here? Broadly, that is the question. Okay? Now, if you look closely, generally what we say is, if you look at the, for example, the earlier expressions, these were something like this. These, so, n basically, if you get confused, always go by first principles, right? So, q was root 2 ds by hc, right? N was equal to d by q, right? Which, if you use this expression here, basically leads you here. Okay? So, same expression, precisely same expression. See, it's by q, right? So, upar chal jayega, right? hcd. That's what you see here. S plus SI because S ki jagah we are taking only S, right? Okay? So the first part I hope is clear to everyone. This was basically comma plus all. Okay? Now, just hear me out. The first expression, by the way, is all about the holding cost, no? Holding cost ke baare mein baat kar raha. How do you calculate holding cost? Average inventory into the cost of that inventory. Q by 2 into H. Which we also saw, call it as a percentage of product cost. Okay? Q by 2. The moment you bring Q by 2. Right? Now just hear me out. If I try to map it in terms of average inventory, right? Average inventory will continue to be Q by 2. Okay? Q by 2. Just hear me out. So HCIMIDI. Okay? Now the issue is that whatever will be the value of Q, something like this will come out, H C B upon 2 S plus SI. Now this is the key part, right? This is the key part. Am I correct in saying that if N is the for the most frequently ordered one, is this comfortable with that? My bad. Just give me a second. So, this is nothing but n by mi. Are you comfortable with this statement, right? This n by mi. So, if there are 10 orders of the most frequent order one, and you will be tagging along after every two orders, there will be total of 5 orders for you. Total of 5 orders for you. Right? So, because there are a total of 5 orders for you, what is going to happen is that if you again go back to this formula, right? Q d by q is equal to n. Okay? So n, if I try to put it in terms of, this is my ni, right? Mere item, this is for me, right? So d i q, right? So if I use these two expressions together, I hope you can see that the equivalent expression will be di by q is equal to n by mi, or this common n can be written as di mi by q. Okay, di mi. So that is precisely where this mi di is coming from. Mi di. Somewhat clear, or do you want me to solve it even further? I can do that. It's not a problem.
Sir, I understood.
Understood it, right?
Yeah.
I got. But basically, it's a relationship between. See, ye n kya hai? This n is for the common, I mean, the most frequent one, right? But because the relationship between most frequent one and the less frequent ones is this, so that is why this is coming all the time. Or jab sabse common hoga to just one. So that is why that mi di is coming. If you want to give it a go later on and you still don't get, just let me know and I can maybe work with you in detail. Of it. It's perfectly fine. What else? Anybody else have any other question?
Sir,
yes, something.
In step one, step two, can there be any chance that the step two ni is greater than the step one ni because the denominator is reducing? So in that example, so someone mentioned that the highest frequency was 11.
Brilliant question. I think that's a brilliant question. Technically speaking, just give me a second. Mathematically, let me try to understand. S value is going out. If S value is very large, then possibly, if you remove it, the Ni values would go higher, yes, which is to be expected. But do you want them to go even beyond that, right? If it goes beyond that, then the issue is that how do you make it more frequent or less frequent? Yeah, I think that's an interesting question, which again, I think linked to the question which I think Abhishek was also asking. So basically what will happen is we'll try to tag it along all the time. We'll have left no choice but to tag it along all the time. Because if it goes higher, right, you cannot have it more frequency. The logic is one item should come most. The problem is if you now say the other type item will have to come more than this, then this becomes more frequent one. So the solution will be, again, that's why it's a heuristic. The solution will be to tag it along in each of the order. So basically, mi will be equal to one. Every time. But I think that's a brilliant question. And in terms of solution, as per the heuristic, because you cannot go more than more frequent ones, you have no choice but to tag along all the way. Brilliant question. That's a brilliant question. So that is the maximum possible frequency. Think of it like that. Maximum possible frequency.
Okay, sir.
Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. What else? Anybody else has any other question? Happy to take it.
Sir, in previous formula, we have used SI in denominator.
Are we talking of this somewhere around somewhere here?
Yes, sir. Like the S star we calculate by simply summing the SL, SL.
Right, correct.
But in this formula, we have divided SI by MI.
Yes. So, very question, as I was explaining, that remember, SI is item specific, right? Item specific. So the point is, in the earlier model, when all the orders had all the items, each of those order would include the common order cost as well as the item specific cost. But now what is happening is, because some of the items are coming some of the time, it does not make sense for me to have for every order SI. So for example, if M is equal to 2, it means after every two orders, this specific cost will be incurred, or unitary method would tell us on a per order basis, this is the cost that will be incurred, right? Because every three orders ke baad, we are getting this. So on a per order basis, it will be SI by MI. Are you getting my point, Rahul?
Yes, understood.
Yeah. Okay. Excellent. Anybody else has any sort of question? Any hypothetical or all of those are more than anything? See, Allah, rest of it is there. What you are doing, you know, imbibe intuitively is what will stay with you. All good? Everybody comfortable? As always, the drill, right? Going forward is the same, right? If you're comfortable, move to solution. right? And now I will start troubling you a bit more in terms of solutions. So go ahead, solve it. If you want, I can show you the data. Do you want me to show you the data once more, or you have the data with you? Let me maybe just show you, you know, just for the benefit of it, somebody's missing out. So this is the data. I'll just bring you to the algorithm one after that. So 12,000, 1,200, same data, right? Because we'll see whether there is a benefit or not. We'll see whether there's a benefit or not. Okay. So common order cost, product specific product cost, holding cost, unit cost, etc. 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 That's it. Right. So the same data, 20% of product cost, item specific cost, common demand. Okay. Now allow me to go back. Just go step by step by step. Take as much time as you need. This is the place where most people end up making mistakes. Like, not my experience. Generally, most people end up making mistakes somewhere or the other. Somehow, sometimes MI may they don't take it rational. Sometimes, you know, they miss out on SNO, MI. Lot of mistakes happen, lot of mistakes, which we do not want to happen. Right? I mean, you might say calculation to computer work is fine, but you should also understand exactly what is happening. So just go step by step by step. Just identify what is the final optimal number of orders and the total cost. So just identify these two things. Go step by step. Step one, step two. Now remember, step one is what we already did. Right? Step one, what we already did earlier. Right? So do it. Just go step by step by step by step. Any confusion, any problems, stop me there and there. Take, just go step by step. Take as much time. You know, if you want 10 minutes, 10 minutes is perfectly fine. Just go step by step. Right? So, okay, I'll give you maybe 10 minutes or so. Right? Take 10 minutes. So after that, you know, let me request someone to move right with this one. Okay, so let's go with maybe Gunjan and Deepak and Shashank. Okay, these three. Okay, right. You are our, you know, flag bearers. 267, 153, and Shashank does not have available. But okay, what a problem. Go ahead, do it. Cut up. Take your time. Maybe 10, 12 minutes. Maybe 10 minutes is fine. Okay. Need another angle to get it correct. My sixth sense is telling me that a lot of people have just, you know, wandered off. Naheen. Trishul, all well?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I had always had a question. By any chance, are you related to Sangeet Pal Chaudhary?
No, sir.
Okay. He's a well-known guy in, you know, business models and all those things. Anyway, just thought of checking.
Just wanted to see the slide, like
which one?
The original slide, sir. Like
the data, the one with the data.
Yes. Yes,
so,
sir.
Okay, no problem. So 12,200, 120, 4,000, 1,000 each, and 20% of the product cost, which is 500. All right.
Okay, sir.
Good to go, Abhishek.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Step by step, no hurry. It's cool. I'm so bad at remembering whom I know. Requested to tell us. Sort of scouts all of you.
Sir,
yes, please.
Sir, for this n double cap, we have two, like n for h, n for k.
Yes, correct, absolutely correct. So basically, we'll have to do it. I think the light pro comes with the most frequent. For the medium pro as well as heavy pro, you will calculate this.
Yes, I have calculated. Like, and then how to merge these two for calculating m?
Oh, m will be different. One will be for medium pro, one will be for heavy pro.
Okay.
So, for example, if it's coming out to be 13/7, round it off higher. Right? If it's coming out to be 13/4, round it off higher. Okay. So, dono ka, remember, that's why there is a summation here, because MI values are different. Okay.
Yes.
2 is equal to 11 is equal to 11.47. Okay, great, Ravish. Then let's see know what the others is, in case somebody else is also getting 11.4, 11.5. Gokul, all well?
Yes, sir.
Good. I hope it, no problems in terms of calculations, right?
No, sir.
Which step are you on, Gokul?
Sir, I'm that MI.
Good. Please go ahead. Any problem, let me know. Get good. Please get good. Step by step, I already have one which is 11.47. In case anybody else is getting something like this, Manisha, how much are you getting? Christopher? In progress?
Yeah, yes, I'm doing it.
Oh, there are two Manishas. Okay. Okay, great. Thank you. Suddenly I realized. All right. What about the other Manisha? Is it all right? I mean, you're stuck somewhere? Okay, all good. 11.47. All right. Okay.
Yes, sir. Working on it, sir.
Great. Excellent. Thanks. So, So, possibly 11.47 should be correct. I mean, two people independently verifying it should be correct. Total cost, I know it's boring. If you feel like it, do it. Okay, as a teacher, I should not say that. Do it, huh? Do it. Yes. I need two Shubhams also. I just need that. Are both the Shubhams, everything all right? Things progressing all right?
Yes, sir.
Good. Oh, 11.47. Brilliant. I think so many people getting it independently should be correct. Okay, we all have an answer on the cost also. I have no idea what the cost. I would request somebody to please verify that. 130. I think earlier it was 136. 136, right? So it seems again reduction. Should be all right. Should be all right there. Let's see. No, just in case some other person also gets it. Others, no, go step by step. Don't get hurried. Absolutely no problem. Take your time. And I tell you, right, this is the place where people, you know, lose a lot of marks. And this is what helps me in grading also, right? Normal distributions. So we require questions like this also. Now you don't mistake up. Teaching makes you a sadist. Right. So anyway. Hurry up, hey, you would have got the answer by now, I would think. Your name? Oh, not yet.
Sir, I had a question.
Oh yeah, fire away.
Sir, like in this question, we are getting our order frequency as 11.47.
Right.
Like in the previous one we did, it was around 9.75.
Correct.
So which element of the total cost is the area where we are reducing our cost if our order frequency is going up?
Brilliant question. I'll just know. Just for the moment, others, if you don't mind, I'll just show you. Show it to you, right? So just give me a second. This was the answer initial. Right? In terms of total ordering cost. Total holding cost, right? Obviously, these two would be equal. If this is equal to this, this is equal to this, this is equal to sum also has to be equal, right? So basically, yes, the total ordering cost initially was half of it. So roughly 77.5. 0.5, right? I mean, 77,500 rupees, right? Now, see what is happening. Right? 77,500. So, what is happening basically is you're able to reduce both. We're able to reduce both. Because in these cases, it was symmetric. In this case also, what we'll see shortly is something along the lines of, again, both of these reducing. So long story short, whenever you're able to reduce it, both the costs are reducing. Both the costs are reducing. But I get a sense that maybe that was not the question that you had. You had some other question, right?
Yes, sir. So like in this total cost formula,
okay,
which one is the part where we are significantly reducing our cost to 130,000.
Ah, like okay, 130, okay, yeah, okay, okay. Maybe now I get a better sense. Basically, the key part is this one, right? Yeah, yeah, absolutely right. That's the SI part, absolutely right. See, let's try to understand why, the logic. The logic is earlier, when all the items were delivered all the time, right? ABC, second order, maybe ABC, third order. What was happening was, you were incurring truck cost, I mean common order cost. You were incurring small, specific order cost, specific order. Abhi kya ho raha hai? A hamesha hai. But maybe, depend on the values. Maybe B is coming every second time, and let's say C is coming every fourth time. So if you close the SI pay, what you say, right? Nahi SI nahi hai. One SB is there, all three. So SI is the portion where we generally were saving cost. Earlier, compared to independent ordering and then common ordering, joint ordering, what was happening was, when it was independent for every order, A ke liye bhi S, B ke liye bhi S, capital S, C ke liye bhi capital S. When you combine the two, ABC, only one S. So the difference between the first model and the second model was capital S, which is common order cost. The difference between the second and the third model is the item specific order cost. So basically, this is the expression where fundamentally you are making that. Does that answer your question?
Yes, it does.
Okay. Others, go ahead. Cost, kitna ra, right? 11, okay, 130,767. All right. Anybody else is getting something like this or in the vicinity of this? 130,767. Same. Okay. Okay. Should be correct. Maybe 2-3 minutes more for others to also catch up. It's just not the same thing, right? When you are not in the same room, right? Not able to bugger. So somebody is sitting beside you or behind you or in front of you. Take it. What's the point of picking the other lucky ones? I hope nobody's stuck or nobody's completely lost. I hope that is not the case, right? Baki to all of you are geniuses, so when the time calls for it, you can always do. I know, right? You don't really need me for that. It's not an issue. Maybe a couple of minutes more.
Sir.
Yes, please.
Still in this case, even the previous case,
uh-huh,
the annual holding cost for individual product should be, uh-huh, equal to their ordering cost.
Oh, now?
Now or even
just
the...
Similar to EOQ, I presume, right? That's where you are.
Yes.
Right? No, unfortunately. Remember.
So that would be set off.
Yeah, because the problem is abhi balance humne pura break kar diya, right? Sorry. We have, by insisting that you only come some of the time, we have broken the balance.
Yes.
Right? So that's why that thing, item ka sabka barabar, that will no longer hold, unfortunately.
Okay.
But I think another very interesting question. See, that's how you build intuition, right? In fact, let me share with you something, right? I was talking about the Deloitte thing, right? Somebody had a couple of questions were asked. So For those of you interested, you know, what is the practical implication and the whole story, which I think was telling you, you know, even after being a lot of MBAs and this, you know, and this and that, people tend to miss out on what is being taught. So this, so Deloitte did this empirical study that I just shared, right? Lead to the news vendor model. If you get something, look at this. For those of you interested, anyway, you know, story for a different. So, anyways, is it, maybe 1 minute more, right?
Hello. Yeah. Sir, in step three, we round it off to higher integer, right?
Which one?
Step three, we round off MI to higher
right,
integer.
Right, right. So, for example, in this case, if I were to show you, this would be rounded
yes,
off to. This would be rounded off to 5.
Sir, is it possible that we round it off to a lower integer and still get lower cost?
See, there is nothing which prevents that from happening mathematically, to be honest.
Yes,
right?
Sir.
But remember, the behavior, because the behavior is very flattened out, that is why for most practical reasons, we don't worry too much. Remember the curve, right? The curve, the cost curve is something like this. So very flat. So that's why we don't worry too much. That's why we don't worry too much. But yeah, mathematically, there is nothing which is preventing us from you know, doing that. There's absolutely nothing which is preventing us from doing that. Mathematically, it can.
Okay, sir. So, sir, we can round it off to anywhere, right?
Yes, yes. It's just to maintain consistency across everything, right? So that you can maintain consistency. Generally, the thumb rule is to go high, generally. And we don't worry too much. We don't worry too much.
Okay, sir.
But again, mathematically, there is no boundary that, no, okay, iske baad nahi hona. Absolutely nothing like that. Right? So, the cost, which I think somebody mentioned, was 130 something, right? 130 something. As always, if you look at the ordering behavior, this is the new ordering behavior. Okay. But it means, just compare it to what was happening earlier. Am I correct in saying that now the item which was ordered very frequently is being ordered again? This is slightly, this is like, in fact, I would like to compare this 11.47 to the independent ordering case, right? Remember what was happening in independent ordering? Can somebody give me an explanation? Ki independent series, otherwise you are trying to order it more than time, more times than independent. What's the logic? Is the question clear to everyone, right? See, that's these questions, each and every assumption that you make, right? Each and every step that you take. What I'm claiming is, when it was independent, then the value was this. When it is this process called Taylor aggregation, then the value is this. Why is this happening?
So this is to synchronize the other orders that will be coming. So if, for example, if it's 11 years only, then that problem of not synchronization, and then the heavy pro would not be, we'll not be able to order heavy pro in batches with light pro.
Interesting. That's a very interesting point. Yes, yes, yes. Anything else? No, somebody thinks there could be a reason, I think. What else could be a logic? Right? Usse bhi zyada ho gaya. Independent se bhi zyada. Earlier it was 11, now it's 11.47. Of course, it's nearer to that. It's not that far off. But still, it's different, right? It's different. See, as I think Utkarsh was pointing it out, if I'm not mistaken, that the idea is about synchronization, right? Sorry. The idea is about synchronization. The idea is about synchronization. And you want to ensure that. You want to be able to ensure that, right? You know, synchronization happens perfectly, as you said, right? And that is why it's entirely possible that values change. It means it's nothing untoward. It's nothing untoward. The more important part is the cost, right? When we started, it was 155,000 something. Then it became 136,000 something. Now it is 130,000 something. Right? And I hope you realize that the movement from independent ordering to common ordering to tailored ordering, this would make a lot of difference if and only if the value of capital S is high. Mahisa to saving hara, right? If the value is minuscule, not much of a difference will come. And the movement from common ordering to tailored ordering would be, relatively speaking, beneficial if capital SI values are small, right? Agar S chota hai, tabhi value hai, SI chota hai, tabhi, sorry, my bad. Thinking, saving and writing something else, right? So what I'm claiming is, let me repeat, the movement from independent ordering to common ordering would make sense if S value is high. And this would be a lot more beneficial if SI value is high, right? Because that's the trigger, that's the trigger, that's the trigger that we're using. What is the beauty of tailored aggregation? If tablets are sold very, very frequently, laptops can tag along, and maybe AIOs, all-in-ones need to be tagged along very, very well. So the beauty is, this is what we like to call tailored aggregation. Tailored. Aggregate, so we can, but this is not blind aggregation like what we did earlier. Now it's a very, very tailored aggregation. We are trying to handle cost trade-offs at different levels. Right? Different. This brings us to the end of this domain. In case there are any follow-up questions, I'm happy to take. Otherwise, we can move forward. Any questions on this part so far? Okay. If that is done, then we move on to the future, the next part of the discussion, which is all about demand uncertainty. And now, basically, right now, we were not talking about demand uncertainty. We were fixed like it's right? We were talking about fixed. Now, what we do is, we try to bring demand uncertainty. And as all of us already know, that the most obvious way to counter it is safety stock. And the agenda going forward is to understand safety stock, right? Is to understand cycle service level, right? And to be able to understand fill rate. These are the three things. We are not going to put lot size constraint in this, in the sense that if you don't mind, can you just maybe expand on what kind of lot size constraint are we talking about?
So where the value of S would be restrained to some number of units, so that S will incur that S again, that 4,000 again, if the order quantity is more than 400 or 500.
If I understand correctly, want to put a constraint on this?
Yes. That lot size per order, per transport kind of.
Yes. Fair point. So typically what happens is that, if sufficient capacity is available, then it's all right. But if capacity is not available, typically what you would do is, the one which is very highly ordered, right? If it takes away the entire truck capacity, that problem is solved independently. And for the remainder, you do the tailoring. Are you getting what I'm trying to say? If there is something which is already now hogging that much of it, you remove it, you handle it separately, and others you try to solve separately. Right? And then there are other constraints also. What kind of other constraints? Will tailored aggregation provide the lowest cost? Yes, till the point the difference is there, it will provide benefit, but the benefit will go on reducing. Right, Ravish? Benefit to aega, but reduce hota rahega. Reduce. And in a limiting case, it will tend to what we saw earlier. So now the question is, this is all about putting lot size constraint to handle these items differently. And then there are a lot of other issues also. For example, what are the other issues? Typically, if you want to organize, for example, a distribution center, right? There are many ways to organize distribution centers, but some of it is also because of category. So white goods handled separately, all the other goods handled again separately. So both of these items are being handled separately, right? So if truck is the constraint, you try to understand if there is a product which is very fast moving, which is having high volumes, high velocity, usko alag kar, right? Keep it separate. And there are others you handle in this aggregated manner. So all these issues will keep on cropping up. And remember, the system has to be refined. That's why you see a lot of papers, even after 100 years, inventory management keep on coming in, talking of different points. Right? Okay, so now, as I was saying, we may not are interested to understand that, you know, okay, what do we do in the case of demand uncertainty? And demand uncertainty is countered through safety stock in general. And we will also try to talk about the interplay between service level, fill rate, and safety stock. Safety stock, everyone knows. Service level, I would just maybe spend some time. Yeah. So when I say that 95% service level is what I'm targeting, right? For, I don't know, for this keyboard, let's say, right? It's HP keyboard, right? I want to meet some 95% service level. One of the most important metrics in all of management is CSL, psych service level. So what does this CSL mean? As I explained, 95% CSL means, and remember, it's a multiple replacement scenario, right? Multiple scenario. 95% CSL means in 95% of the replenishment cycles, I will be able to meet all the demand from stock. And in 5% of the cycles, there will be a shortage. Okay? If I say 90% service level, what it means is that in 90% of the replenishment cycles, I would be able to meet all the demand from stock, and in 10% of the cycles, there will be a shortage. Is everybody comfortable with the service level concept? Anybody has any confusion? Etc. Right? Service level, I hope everybody is comfortable, right? We'll talk of all of this, continuous review, periodic review, etc. Okay? Now, let's try to understand. Just by looking at this, is this continuous review or periodic review? Just by looking at this. This, I hope everybody is able to tell, right? Because see, you don't want to make mistakes. Just by looking at the first dabba which I have created, right? Continuous or periodic? Continuous. Reorder point, right? Reorder, continuous review, who should know? Continuous, right? Continuous review. Reorder point, continuous review. Reorder point comes in continuous review, right? So essentially what we are trying to understand is, okay, nevertheless, take it. Just a quick refresher, right? Because I need to take everyone along. Just hear me out. If my demand is certain, right? My demand is certain and my lead time is also certain, right? So imagine, just imagine that demand I know for sure is 10 units per day and my lead time for sure is 2 days. First of all, I can calculate how much to order, okay? When to order, reorder point. Am I correct in saying that reorder point should be 20 units? So basically what I'm claiming is, let's see, after EOQ say you hit a threshold of 20, you should order once more. Logic is, 2 days for certain, order will come. And for sure, 20 units will last through the 2 days. So reorder point should be 20, right? Everybody's with me, right? Reorder point should be 20 when both things are certain. The moment, for example, demand is uncertain. Suppose now the demand becomes 10,3. Now demand can be 0, 10, 50, 30. Am I correct in saying that I would require something now? So reorder point, which is earlier nothing but, which is called demand during lead time. Demand during, this will be the demand during lead time, right? Mean demand basically. Average demand, mean demand during lead time. Will be mean demand during lead time plus safety stock. This buffer we keep to counter variability in demand. Everybody with me? Anybody who's any confusion? All good? Now see, when everything was fixed, right? When everything was fixed, if I keep the reorder point as 20, I'm certain that by the time after 2 days my EOQ order comes, no problem, no shortage. But the moment demand is uncertain, demand can go beyond 20 also. So that's why we end up keeping safety stock. Right? And how do you decide safety stock? Safety stock is the $1 trillion formula, which I mentioned earlier also. Safety stock is Z sigma. Z is
demand, sir?
Yes, please. Yes, Abhijit.
Demand was like average, right? I mean, which you had...
Right. So when everything was certain, demand was 10 per day and lead time was 2 days. What I'm claiming is you should order the moment you have only 20 units left. But the moment demand is uncertain, 20 will not last you 2 days. You need to give something extra. And that extra is what we like to call safety stock. Kitna safety stock? That is. And remember, no matter how much safety stock you keep, you still cannot meet 100% of the demand all the time.
Yes, sir.
Right? So that is why we bring a concept of CSL, that I want to be able to meet 90% of the cycles on demand and 10% of the cycle will be shortage. And this is the formula for buffer stock. Or in other words, the expression for reorder point becomes demand during lead time plus safety stock, which is nothing but mean demand into lead time plus Z value, standard deviation demand, and square root of lead time. Is everybody okay with this so far? If not, please let me know, because this is where the things would start getting interesting. And after that, when we talk of contracts, for them, it's completely different game all game altogether. Everybody's okay with this? Right? Okay. So now essentially what is happening here is that, for example, if I give you the demand, if I give you the standard deviation, if I give you lead time, if I give you a reorder point, can you calculate safety stock? Yes. See, what will be the demand during lead time? It will be 5,000. Right? And if your reorder point is 6,000, am I correct in saying that you are keeping 1,000 units as safety stock, right? Is it okay? Vikash, is it okay? Kritika, Kesham, all good? Chalega?
Yes, sir.
Excellent.
Yes, sir.
Kritika, you seem very disappointed. Haan, sir, if you are saying so. Oh, everything all right?
No, sir.
I hope supply chain is not too boring operations, though by definition it's somewhat boring. I cannot really tell that.
No, sir, it's interesting.
Okay, now that you have said it, you have 2 extra marks for you, right? Maybe all right. So, Kesham, everything is all right, right? All good? Okay.
Perfect. Yes, sir.
Perfect. Right. Great. So now that's how you can. Now the question is, please.
Lead time is the amount of time.
The time between order placement and order delivery. Right? If you have placed an order, then when will you get it? I mean, think of it like, you know, you place the Amazon order, it shows you, right? Delivery in 7 days. So that becomes the underlying lead time. Okay? Time between order placement and order delivery. Now, somebody might come and say, yeah, 1,000 units ka buffer achha hai ki nahi. So that is why we generally do not work with absolute numbers. 50 units matlab kya? Demand se link karo na. So that is why, rather than thinking in terms of numbers, it thinks in terms of probability. And that's why CSL is arguably the single most important metric in supply chain. Single most important metric. Because it gives you a sense of aggregate. Ki baat koi 1,000 units rakha, 1,000 units buffer matlab kya? Right? So that is why we typically think in terms of cycle, service, level. Don't worry, what I would now request all of you is go back, try to refresh on whatever was covered in the first year. When we come on Monday, this Monday we don't have a class, I think, right? We're meeting on Wednesday, and even on Wednesday, there's a bit of a question mark, to be honest, because of some administrative reasons. Anyway, I'll keep you posted. So, am I looking at the correct way? So now, anyway, that will take it up. Okay, so once we meet, we'll start from this point. I would earnestly request all of you to maybe quickly brush through, you know, ops, etc. If you get some time. I know all of you are busy. Netflix and so many other things also. Right. So anyway, what are all of you watching? Some good movie or TV series has come out, which is interesting all of you. So you know, I'm open to some good suggestions, some good ones, right? Which random one movie. Now this though. Oh, Tenet, to yeah, HD film, yeah. Saran, you were also like me, right? Now I already downloaded, right? So, okay, I should not say that. What tell, sir? Just Tenet, everybody's watching Tenet. Baki koi nahi dekh raha.
Some movies vagera, sir.
Sure. No, not to worry. Chali, yaar. Let me not overstay my welcome, all of you. You have so many other things to do. Please upload. Sit down, I have already uploaded. These are already there. before the session, because I got a request from a couple of people to upload it beforehand. So I already uploaded these, right? Check if they are not accessible, just let me know. I'll maybe upload them much more. Is that all right? Okay, so see you all in the next session. Till then, goodbye and have a good week ahead. Let's see when we are able to meet, right? Let's see. Great, thank you. Have a good day.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.